Hi, my name is Max Lenderman. I've been fortunate enough to be at the forefront of some major seismic marketing trends and shifts. The first one was experiential marketing and the movement from brands kind of espousing a promise or messaging something to more of an experience-based approach to how customers grow their trust with brands. At the same time, I've been really interested and really involved in the notion of brand purpose. As a matter of fact, last year the ANA called the term brand purpose the term of the year because a lot of brands and a lot of organizations are looking at it, and some of them are scratching their head and others are diving in head first. And when talking about brand purpose, I often say purpose is the new digital. I hashtag it almost all my posts on LinkedIn or Twitter, and I speak a lot about it. And it's gotten a lot of really positive feedback because it's a great analogy to what I think is the massive shift in how people are appropriating, using, badging, and elevating and amplifying brands these days. And it really comes down to purpose and why does the brand exist in the world. And so look at it this way. The banner ad is only 22 years old. Now think about digital and in your marketing career and in your career in general and looking how brands are built, etc. Think about how much the world has changed in those past 22 years and how some of those really massive brands who didn't get on the digital train, where they are now and how much they're struggling, whether they exist or not. And think about how those early adoptive brands that got into the digital space, you know, head first, think where they are now and where their customer base is and where the competition is trying to catch up. So purpose is the new digital. So let's take that analogy. For most companies right now, they say they're purposeful and they'll point to their CSR report, usually buried in page 40 or 50 in the quarterly report for a corporation. And it's usually centered around sustainability, governance, community building, etc. And they say, yeah, we have brand purpose. Check this out. Look at how much we've donated. To me, that's like a company that is looking around going, do we really need a webpage? Really? Then there's some companies that are saying, hey, we have a really good brand story in what we do through our CSR work, right? So, and then they elevate it to the point of, you know, even Super Bowl commercials. So if you saw the Verizon ad, for instance, they're one of their major tenets for corporate social responsibility is supporting first responders. And so they're making a campaign out of it and they're showing the world, hey, this is actually what we're doing out here, right? Same thing for AB InBev in the Super Bowl when they touted their solar capacity and their sustainability capacity, but at least they're elevating that CSR story into really good creative and telling the world about it. That's akin to having a webpage when digital first started out. Now, there are some brands that are seeing that their role in culture revolves around some kind of positive social impact, and they're going and putting their money where their mouth is. The likes of Levi's around gun control, or Dick's around gun control, or Nike with the Kaepernick ad, right? So they are elevating their status in culture by taking on positive social impact. And that's like kind of having an app, right? You're beyond the curve in terms of what the digital kind of ecosystem needs, and you're going a little bit further. And then there's the purpose native brands, right? Where their existence has social impact woven into it from day one. Tom's Shoes, Tesla, REI, Patagonia, etc. And these are the brands, if you start looking at it, are the ones that are really kind of becoming the leaders in how modern branding is accomplished and how consumers are interacting and creating brand trust with them, centered around brand purpose. And you see kind of like Airbnb moving into this space and finding a lot of dividends and becoming more purpose-led and talking about inclusivity and talking about we all belong. So you see some really good modern large brands really going into this space and thriving. And then you see a few others that are not doing a great job at all. Like you could talk about the Pepsi Cola and Kendall Jenner ad that was just huge blowback, right, etc. You could talk about Starbucks and some of the things that they've done, whether intentional or not, that kind of had some blowback, and they're kind of navigating what is their purpose in this world, quite frankly, beyond, you know, overpriced coffee. Sorry, Howard. So purpose is becoming a really key component to modern marketing. And the reason is because most people in the world wouldn't care if the majority of brands disappeared. All you have to do is read Havas Meaningful Brands Report or Edelman Brand Trust Report to see that, hey, brands, large brands, are going to have a really hard time being relevant. And to close the loop on why purpose is the new digital, what digital really did is opened up the aperture for commerce and marketing by giving people personal choice and convenience in how they buy brands. I think what purpose is doing is it's actually aligning people's values to the brands that they want to choose, support, and badge themselves with. So it's another element, like if you think about like the Maslow's hierarchy of needs, what purpose does for brands is starts to actualize them. Right? So it's not just kind of meeting the needs of consumers, but actualizing the brand in an anthropomorphic way that really provides that resonance. Now combine that with experiential, right? Real world action. So it's not just messaging that we're sustainable, it's actually going out there and changing operations. It's not just messaging that we are against gun violence, but actually going out and lobbying, right? So creating mass movements, creating opportunities for people, like-minded people to meet under a brand umbrella and create action that either helps or inspires. And that experiential element of brand building is where the brand trust is gonna lie in the future. So combining brand purpose and brand experience is really kind of the most powerful dynamic that I could see in the next 10 years of where really good brand building is coming from and where incremental revenue exists. Just like digital opened up wide arrays of ways of creating growth and creating opportunities and creating actual profit. Purpose has that same capability. We often say profit is purpose and purpose is profit. And today, in today's modern marketing economy in the US and globally, that is the most truthful statement that I've heard in the year. That's my spiel for today. Hopefully I sparked a thought, but more than that, hopefully I can spark an action. Thank you.